on my side.
Yeah, I've heard about this team that Triss is using, the Groudon, Rayquaza, Slowbro, Venusaur, Raichu, Bronzong. Unfortunately,
RBY special.
Almost, but but I'm really excited to see how it does because I didn't get to watch it earlier today as I was casting a game on this stream, but I'm really excited to see just how Trista can utilize these unique Pokemon choices.
Yeah, well, looks like those unique Pokemon are out on the field immediately. Raichu and Slowbro on the side for Trista, and Kyogre and Vanduris for Lewis. So Trista using some of her more off-meta picks already, while Lewis is sticking... Vanduris is something we haven't seen that much of anymore, but Kyogre is very much on-meta.
Yeah, Raichu is in an interesting situation here because it's super effective on the Kyogre and it can draw any electric attacks that might go towards that Slowbro onto Raichu thanks to Lightning Rod. Mm-hmm. So this is actually a really good position for Trista.
Yeah.
Even though she's using two maybe not considered as powerful Pokemon, especially when compared to the likes of a Thundurus or a Kyogre, but the way she's paired them together, it's going to work out wonderfully in this match. And we see a fake out there on Thundurus.
Yeah, going to immediately fake out onto Thundurus. Looks like the Origin Pulse coming out from Kyogre will connect with the Slowbro and... Oh, looks like it only hits the Slowbro, is not able to deal... deal damage to the Raichu, will instead use the Trick Room. So Slowbro now setting the Trick Room up, going to make sure that Slowbro underspeeds or outspeeds both of those Pokemon.
Yeah, very interesting, because Raichu is a fast Pokemon, so Trick Room does not benefit Raichu at all. However, Slowbro, of course, extremely slow, as its name would suggest.
As you might expect.
So Slowbro certainly will be able to take advantage of this. I'm curious to see if Trista maybe brings in Groudon here instead of Raichu, as that would have a very favorable matchup once it gets a Sunlight up against Kyogre, and of course, it has a great matchup against Thundurus, who can't hit it with an electric-type move. And really, is it really going to want to use an electric move when Raichu's out? That would have to be a pretty sick prediction.
All right, well, Slowbro instead is going to retreat here. So instead, Venusaur will be out. So all three of Trista's original 151 Pokemon are out on the field. And we are going to see...
Oh, roleplay.
Wow, roleplay coming out. Just trying to make sure that the abilities are on the field there. Kyogre will go for another Origin Pulse. Venusaur will not be too concerned about that. Raichu, though, of course, will be taking all of that damage. Will hit the KO in one shot with that Origin Pulse. But Venusaur now out on the field loves being in this position.
Yeah, it does. Although now that Groudon comes out, the Sunlight will come out. That will make Venusaur fast thanks to Chlorophyll. So even though Lewis can roleplay to get the rain back, since Trick Room is up and speed is determined at the very beginning of the turn, Venusaur will actually be the fastest on the field. So Trick Room being in effect right now is actually not good for Trista. However, Groudon is an extremely slow Pokemon, so it may be able to take advantage of this.
Yeah,
but
Venusaur does also have the option of Mega Evolving and waiting a turn.
That's true, and I expect Trista will do that because unless she decides to maybe go for a prediction and protect Groudon and then go for an attack on Venusaur, she's trying to kind of play some mind games here with Lewis. But yeah, protecting Venusaur would certainly be a safe play if she protects Groudon as well, because of course I'm sure she fully expects a role play coming from Thundurus and an attack from Kyogre, so I think she has to protect Groudon no matter what. It's just a question of does she want to risk Venusaur and go for an attack even though both of Lewis's Pokemon are going to be able to move before it, or does she simply protect both?
Yeah, I mean, with having seen all four of her Pokemon now, really needs to protect Groudon as an offensive threat on her team. Lewis will retreat his Thundurus in favor of Ditto. So Ditto now out on the field will be able to use its Imposter. And Lewis, all of a sudden, remember when we said you could only have two restricted Pokemon? He just got another one out on the field copying Trista's own Groudon. Venusaur, though, will go ahead and Mega Evolve this turn. So trying to get rid of that Chlorophyll ability so that it is no longer the fastest thing in the game. Eruption coming out from Trista's Groudon will deal a lot of damage to the Ditto Groudon. Not that much to the Kyogre, but some decent damage as well. Thunder coming out from the Kyogre in the sun will connect with Venusaur, who will be able to use its, I believe that's Grass Knot, onto the Ditto Groudon. Ungolpe Critico. Groudon will go down, and Trista will pick up a Pokemon and even it out.
Yeah, really interesting turn there, because it seems like both of these players, maybe they've got some reads on each other from previous games played against each other.
Because
that was just such crazy reads on both ends. First of all, Thunder and the Sun on a Venusaur going for an Eruption against a Kyogre and a Thunderous that has already showed role play. And then a Grass Knot onto a Thunderous. Surely there were some crazy mind games going on there, but Trista, she's the one who came out ahead on that turn, dealing out massive damage and hardly taking any damage in return. Just a Thunder onto that Mega Venusaur, hardly doing anything.
Yeah, going to be very important for her to conserve her hit points on her Pokemon now, as we do see Trista thought she just got rid of Groudon, but the
one
real
more.
One is in the back. So Lewis now switching in his Groudon now as the dual primals out on the field, which means that the Sun will be up for this turn.
Yeah, Professor Scott's video, you know, he mentioned not being able to face six Arceus, but here we see you do have to face multiple Groudon sometimes, so.
Well, we'll have to see if Trista will be able to battle back from that position. Of course, Venusaur and Groudon aren't slouches, but against Kyogre and Groudon, it's not the best matchup.
Yeah, but now that Venusaur doesn't have Chlorophyll anymore, it certainly helps as long as Trick Room is up. But of course, Lewis knows this and goes for a Protect. Doesn't want his Pokemon to get KO'd while Trick Room is ineffective. Rather stall out the Trick Room and utilize his Pokemon speed for when Trick Room ends.
Yep, double Protect coming out from Lewis. So both of his Pokemon now have blown through their Protect, so there will he could go for more Protects, but it will be very risky. Trick Room is still up.
Yeah, this is where we're going to see some more mind games, because I'm sure Kyogre wants to switch out and bring in Thunderous, but of course Trista might just go for an Eruption and then maybe target Groudon with a Grass move, such as Grass Knot.
Because Powder could be a problem.
That's another potential option, because I don't think Trista really has to worry about Kyogre here. I don't think it can KO either Pokemon, since Venusaur has Thick Fat and is very bulky. I don't think an Ice Beam will knock it out. So I think Trista can just focus on this Groudon, knowing it protected last turn, so the odds of another Protect being successful aren't that high. So whether she goes for an Eruption or simply an Earth Power, that's up to her, depending on what kind of read she has on Lewis.
All right, well, Lewis has decided to switch out his Kyogre, so Thunderous is now back out on the field. Lewis really wants to get in a situation where he can get that rain back up. The Eruption coming out from Trista's Groudon will deal a lot of damage to the Groudon. Another critical hit onto Groudon. Thunderous, though, will go down, so just like the Ditto, Lewis's Groudon eats another critical hit, and a Grass Knot coming through onto Groudon will be enough to pick up the KO. So Trista, with that Eruption, picks up the KO on Thunderous on the switch-in and picks up the KO on the Groudon with the help of that critical hit and with that Grass Knot.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be game. What a great turn for Trista. Not sure how much that critical hit mattered. Eruption did massive damage and put it into that Grass Knot KO range because of the critical hit. But Grass Knot is based on weight, and Groudon, a very heavy Pokemon, doesn't have the highest special defense, so maybe Grass Knot would have been enough to pick up the knockout, but we don't know.
Yeah.
So that's something that it's unfortunate for Lewis, because this is an elimination match here. But for Trista, I'm sure she's very glad to see that. Doesn't have to worry about any kind of damage rolls, just gets to pick up the KO, and now she's going to move on to 5-2.
Yep.
Her hopes of Day 2 Worlds are still alive.
Yep, should be able to just switch this Groudon out for the final Pokemon, the Slowbro, back out on the field. Of course, with that Groudon in the back, Trista can now just bring that in a little bit later, reset the Sun, and that Kyogre. You know, Kyogre deals a lot of damage, but not in the Sun, and especially if it can't even hit the Pokemon in the rain.
No, it hasn't been too accurate this battle when it comes to its origin pulses, though. Its Thunder has been pretty accurate.
Yeah, just Thunder and the Sun.
Yeah, just that.
Thunder and the Sun is more accurate than Origin Pulse in the Rain. Thunder in the Rain, though, is going to get another critical hit onto Slowbro. A lot of critical hits in this match, but Grass Knot coming out from that Venusaur is going to be enough, and that's going to be game. Trista Medin will take it in